entertainment o'clock. All right, if you're welcome to the Porosity Moment, and today, as you can see, I came in dancing because today it's entertainment o'clock. All right, if you're watching this from YouTube, kindly subscribe. Please subscribe. I need you to subscribe. And when you subscribe, don't just subscribe, click on the notification button as well when you subscribe in order to get notified every time we upload a new video, okay? And also, don't forget to follow us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram, follow us on TikTok. Yes, we're on TikTok. If you're on TikTok, follow us. So follow us. We want you to follow us, and that's not miss out of any content we upload, okay? Follow us on all our social media handles. All right. So today, like I said, is entertainment o'clock. Entertainment o'clock. All right. So I'm going to be sharing some entertainment news that are probably not new to you, and it might be new to you as well, because you know, we're in a social media age, so everybody is almost like updated with everything that is happening. But there are still some people that, you know, they are just coming online. And so, okay, today the first thing I want to talk about is about Joel Edoche. He's a Nollywood actor, you know, and he's the son of the renowned Peter Edoche. He's the grandfather. He's a veteran in Hollywood, you know, everybody knows him. And recently he has been coming out to say a lot of things about our generation. Our generation is different from his own generation when he was coming up, and all of that. So his son, Joel Edoche, is a Hollywood actor as well. And most of this, you know, Hollywood are in different... We have Hollywood, and we have Nollywood, if you know what I'm talking about. Alright, so Joel Edoche, he has been acting some movies about rituals and all of that. So he came on social media and like, it was like people are coming to meet him too. They are sending him messages. They want to know how to do money rituals. So I don't understand. So it has come to the point where we don't know where to draw the line between real life situation and movie. Can you imagine? So because he has been acting a lot about rituals and all of that, they naturally assume that he knows something about ritual and ritualism, and they'll be sending him DMs like, oh, tell us how to make this money. Uh-huh. You know the popular phrase that I've been using, well, now they see this money. That is exactly what they are trying to do with him. Like, tell us now, show us the way. But Uncle is not a ritualist, it's just movies, but people will not want to understand. Alright, so the next one is about Peruzzi. Peruzzi is a musician in Nigeria, is a popular musician, and it's associated with the DMW, the Davido crew, and all of that. So he posted that he has found love again. And then our popular Thunder Fire Ukuna, Rick Kazani, was like, my brother. He was like, he's a setup, oh, better stand up. He's a setup. I don't understand. She's somebody who cannot fall in love in peace. Peruzzi said he has found love. Rick Kazani is saying he's a setup. How is he a setup? Leave the poor, the innocent brother alone now. Let him, you know, love is beautiful. So the next is about, oh my god, this is actually the it's a very interesting topic. It's a very interesting news, a very interesting gist, and in fact it flooded the whole weekend. Like, Like it was just everywhere. Like talking about the Obi Cubana's mother's burial, a lot of celebrities were present. You know the funniest part of it is this. There were some Nollywood actors that were spotted at that burial ceremony, and they were spotted acting as ushers. It was that serious. A lot of people were posting, so people were like, if you are not in Upper Anambra right now, you are not, your sugar level is low. So the burial was actually for real sugar daddies. But the ones, the sugar daddies were not, they were not there, their sugar level is very low. That's why they couldn't go. But should be told, that wedding was actually very extravagant. I said wedding. It's not wedding, it's burial. But you know, we're not used to extravagant burial. It's always weddings and, you know. So that's why the slip of tongue happened. It was a burial, but it was so lavish and extravagant. You need to see the way they were just... It was just like a battle of money. Who has money? So if you... It was very... It was... A very big event. A lot of his friends, Cubana, a lot of his friends actually came out for him. They came through for him. They donated cows. I think the total number of cows that were given to you was over 300. Imagine. So there was so much to eat, so much to spend, so much to... And some people specifically actually went there to pick money, you know. So, as they were spending and trading that money will not go to waste. Some people have to pack it. So, that's how it is. But I don't know. But I think there was a time that in Nigeria there was a law that you shouldn't spray money at parties. So, but I don't think that law has been enforced anywhere because, you know, it is what it is. Anyway, that was that about the Obi Cubana's mother's burial. It was the sensation of our weekend. Like, we just see posts everywhere, and about ladies actually went there uninvited, thinking they would be able to like tag along and enter. Some of them were actually flogged out because it's a gathering of people who has, you know, poverty was put to shame at that burial ceremony. It's not good to be poor. We will not be poor. Alright, the next is about filmmaker Yomi Black. Yomi Black is a filmmaker, is director and a producer. His wife celebrated the end of their 9 years marriage. Now, this is not a news that I am happy to share. I don't like hearing about breakups, divorce. It's not my thing. I love stories. But it's just part of life. It happens, you know. These things happen. I don't know what happened in the marriage. I don't know why they are ending it after 9 years. I don't know. But I hope they both find whatever it is they are looking for. All right, so the next is about Katrina Jones. Katrina Jones. If you're a fan of BB Nigeria, you know the person I'm talking about. The boss lady herself. So she took to Instagram to celebrate herself at 27. She celebrated her birthday, and then she took to Instagram to celebrate that at 27 she already has 3 houses. At 27 she has an adorable daughter, and she has many hectares of land, and she has a wonderful husband. At 27, well, I thought we agreed that we won't be talking about age anymore on social media. But anyway, it is what it is. It is what it is. Congratulations to how, even though some people were like commenting that, Katrina, are you sure you are 27 or you are 38? I don't know people's problems. So somebody cannot be 27 in peace again. If she says she's 27, she's 27. You people should leave her alone. So that's that about Katrina. And now this is the kind of news that I love to share. Now, this popular Nollywood actress, Ndima Okoje, she was in this movie, Namaste Wala. Namaste Wala. Yes, it's in Nigerian, in conjunction with Bollywood. Bollywood came to Nigeria for that movie, Namaste Wala. So the star actress in that movie, Ndima Okoje, Also, over the weekend, she got engaged, and I'm so happy for her. She got engaged, and she got engaged to a man who sent her chocolates 2 years ago from London. So this is what happened. She posted on her Insta story that she couldn't find a brand of chocolate in Lagos, and she wanted it. And this man just sent her an email that, you know, okay, I could get you some. And yes, he did. And, you know, the rest they say is what is history. Now she's engaged and I'm so happy for her. She's getting married. It's the kind of news I love to share. All right, so the last thing I want to talk about is, you know, there have been a lot of back and forth in the Nollywood, Yoruba industry, Nollywood. There have been a lot of, you know, call out the Baba Jesha issue, Yabo Ojo getting involved and all of that. So some few weeks back, there was this herbalist that was making rants on social media that said Yabo Ojo was going to die because of her involvement in the case and all of that. And then some few days ago, the herbalist himself actually kicked the bucket. Well, it could actually be a coincidence because the man was obviously an old man. So it could be a coincidence and it could be a back to sender. We don't know, whatever it is, but may so rest in peace. All right, so for today's Entertainment O'Clock, this is all I have for you. And I hope that the next time that I come again, in this dimension, this Entertainment O'Clock dimension, I hope if you have not subscribed, you have subscribed. Please subscribe to this YouTube channel. Follow us on all our social media platforms. And like I said, we are on TikTok. Follow us on TikTok. TikTok. Follow us on TikTok. Follow us on Tumblr. Follow us on Facebook, Instagram. It's like Twitter is still illegal, Abby. Okay. But I hope with the Twitter Andrew and Twitter, every Twitter issue we have in Nigeria will be resolved very soon. So that I can't wait to get back to Twitter. You know, Twitter is what it is. So follow us on all our social media Andrews. Please follow us. And yes. This is the Positive Music Entertainment. And we are live at the Positive Music Entertainment Podcast Studio. We also have a music studio over there. We have a music studio. We have a photography studio. And we have a lot of cameras for rent. We have the Canon camcorder. We have Blackmagic. We have Nikon, we have Sony, we have Canon 80D, 60D. You know, you can just send a DM to us and any kind of event that you want to, you need a camera for, wedding. We have photographers, so if you need our services as a photo company, we are there for you. We will do everything for you. If you need a videographer, if you need a video editor, we are there for you. So, send a DM and your entertainment services will be manned. Did I tell you that my name is Victoria? Okay, in case I didn't, my name is Victoria. And I will see you next time on The Positive Moments. Bye.